Welcome, everybody. You're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today, we're using the Twitter API with Python featuring Nltk for natural language processing. As always, the code will be in the link and description below. You will need to import base64 requests Nltk, and if you do not have it, install it now, as well as regular expressions. You need to have a Twitter account. After you sign up for Twitter, you can just look for the developer.twitter page. This is what I put in the Google search bar. So after you click this, you're going to have a page that should open up. And on the right-hand side, you'll see a create app. Then you want to create the app, put a name for the app, fill in any required line such as these. After you fill out everything, give a basic description of what the use case is for this app, and then you will hit create. After you create it, then you need to go and hit this button right here for the keys and tokens and do a copy. Okay, so feel free to pause the video and do that real quick. Now, what you need to do, you need to cut and paste those credentials that you had. That'll be your client key and the secret key, and you paste those in here. All right. These are fake, so don't try to use these. After you do that, we need to actually do some encoding for the credentials so we can use them. So let's do some string formatting, okay? So let's take in each one of the keys. Yeah, the client and the secret keys. And to format, what do? We just cut and paste the names of those in. And we do some encoding in terms of ASCII. And then we need to do some base64 encoding. So I do base64.b64 encode, and we're going to call the secret key that we just did, and then we'll cut and paste this name real quick. And we need to do a decode back to ASCII, so you're converting this into binary and then formatting this into ASCII. Also, I like to say this beginning portion of code that I'm doing here I found on GitHub, and there's a link for it below, so I wanted to give credit to the developer who did this. Now, we need to make a connection, but what's really going on here? So just go to the developer website, and if you look on the developer website, we're looking at the authentication portion and looking at doing a post. So we scroll down and we see this right here. We say, okay, what's really going on with this? So let's look at an example. So to do the post, you're calling the API. After you call the API, you need to get some authorization. And you're using this right here. And what this is your key that you just created. And you need to use this formatting of content type and take this. And you also need the grant type client credentials. So if you pay attention to this, that's how we set this up here. Where you're calling the API, then you're doing the authorization for your token, and you're calling the same thing as above, where you're filling in now your specific key, and you just cut and paste all of this in. Then you are going to send your request through the post, where we need to now cut and paste these in, call the headers and your data, and you should get a response code of 200 if it went through, and if it didn't, you're going to get like a 404 error. So there we go. We're good on that. Now, we need to do the response and the printout from this. I'm not going to show it because it'll show my token here. But if you printed this off, you'll see token type, bearer, and then access token, and then your token information if you print this line. So let's fill this in real quick. So when you get down here, what you need to do is, when you get down here, what's occurring is that you're creating your token, and it's giving you a token type saying that you're the one who owns it, basically. I'm not printing mine off because it'll show my information right here. I could always reset and do a new one, but I'm lazy. So that's what's getting stored right here, is you're actually calling your token, and you're going in and you're going to now do a GET request for the data from Twitter. Okay, so then we can go in here and look at what's going on. Let me see if that's what this page is. There's two pages we need to look at. Okay, so here's the GET request where you're calling in the web address. If you pay attention to this formatting and you have this Q symbol, we'll discuss that in a second. Then you have your header, right? And then you have a few other things down here. So let's break this up and see what's going on. So we are putting inside our token here, which is perfect. So that's good. And then what else do we have? We have, here's the token. And then we have also, so you have this queue. And let's go into another page and look at what's going on. So here's the parameters that you can look for. So the queue is basically printing off all of the characters that are inside of the tweet. And there's other parameters. This one in particular is required. Everything else is optional. So what we're looking for here is tweets that are relevant to climate change. You can put any topic you're interested in here. And I'm only looking at the recent tweets. And then this can be a count of up to 100 tweets per page. I'm just going to show 8. So you're taking your URL that we saw in one of the last links, and that's what you need. And now you get your GET request where you're putting in your parameters, your header, and then the actual URL. Then we can print off and see what all of these tweets look like. And they're all hidden within status. So just think of looking at a dictionary. And inside of that status, you need to look around and you'll say, oh, okay. So now we need to get inside of text, which is storing the actual tweet. You can also have different things like the user ID, their name, the user mentions, maybe a specific person, see if there was any hashtags associated, or any external URLs. All right. Then what we can do is print off the actual tweets. All right. So this print off these tweets. So I need to iterate through the JSON tweet data, and I'm just going to print the status for the tweet. Oh, didn't pay attention. I need to call the status. What is the status is? Statuses. Text. Maybe it's text. There we are. So here's the text that we're looking at, and we separate it by new lines. So that's perfect. This right here is just telling you that you're dealing with retweets. Some of them have links to the tweets that you can look at here, and you can decide to store those if you want. Now, I decided to convert these to lowercase so we could do some text processing. So all I did was just iterate through this and then just convert it all to lower and store each tweet as a string. So that's what I did here. Then iterate through and store the URLs. So we're doing some regular expressions here. So I need to do a regular expression dot find all, and then from there I would like to find everything that's within a string using this. Then I'm going to find anything that has at least an HTTP and take all of those, and then take my iterator. Okay, there we are. So the only one that was left that had a URL is the last one. So that worked out perfect. So let's now remove this so we could do our string processing. So we're going to do a regular expressions substitution method, which is almost similar to what we just did, where we need to basically take this and paste that in there. And then we're going to substitute with an empty string and then call what we're iterating. Now we removed it from the last one. Let's do some string splitting, where we're going to split each one of these strings into a nested list of words. Okay, so let's just make some default just blank empty list where we're going to store everything. And then I'm going to take the remove URLs. And from there, I'm going to create something called a tokenizer, which will be from Nltk, where I'm taking the regular expression tokenizer. And then I'm only wanting to deal with words. And then I need to append my data. So I'm taking in the tokenizer, and then we're going to use the method of tokenize from Nltk, throw in the iterator, and then see what that looks like. Here's everything. Let's just look at one entry. Here's the first entry, and here's all the words that are inside that entry. But now let's get rid of stop words like it, and I, weird things like that that are just useless. So then we need to do a stop word. So stop words will be from Nltk, where we call stop words dot words, and we're calling the English version. And then we need to iterate through what we just created, and then I'm just going to print this off because I don't want to do anything for this now. And I'm doing a list comprehension where we're basically saying we're doing a comparison of the stop words for the nested list of strings that we have, and basically anything that's not a stop word, just keep it. So Nltk, what was it called? There we are. So here we are, we took out the stop words. You could do further processing and take out these digits, which can be kind of useless. You could do stemming or lamentation, just depends on what you're looking for your analysis. But this is a basic to start you up with Nltk and basic natural language processing. All right. So I'd like to say thank you for watching. Please like and share. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you do, turn on that notification bell. As always, thank you for watching. I hope this brought utility to somebody. Also, I'm reiterating the portion from above, the Twitter API code, was not mine. And it came from this GitHub here. All right. So I'd like to reinforce that. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.